We'll continue our discussion on the topic of calculus of variations. In part 1, we have considered the problem of finding a curve y of x joining two points x1, y1 and x2, y2 lying on a plane that minimizes some quantity that is a property of the curve. Here, we will try to derive the Euler's differential equation, which is a differential equation satisfied by such minimizing functions.
We assume that there exists an admissible function y of x that minimizes the integral I equal to integral x1 to x2 f of x y y dash dx, that is y double dash of x is continuous and y of x1 equal to y1, y of x2 equal to y2. We obtain the required differential equation for y of x by comparing the values of I that correspond to neighboring admissible functions. Since we have assumed that y of x gives the minimum value to the integral I, I will increase if we disturb y of x slightly. To construct these disturbed functions, let eta of x be any function such that eta double dash of x is continuous and eta of x1 equal to eta of x2 equal to 0. If alpha is a small parameter, then y bar of x equal to y of x plus alpha eta of x represents a one parameter family of admissible functions. Consider this figure. Here, y of x is the minimizing function. Eta of x is a curve such that eta of x1 equal to eta of x2 equal to 0, and this is a representative of the one parameter family y bar of x equal to y of x plus alpha eta of x. For each family of this type, that is, for each choice of the function eta of x, the minimizing function y of x belongs to the family and it corresponds to the value of the parameter alpha equal to 0. With a fixed eta of x, we substitute the values of y bar of x and y bar dash of x equal to y dash of x plus alpha eta dash of x into the integral 1 and obtain I as a function of alpha given by integral x1 to x2 f of x y bar of x y bar dash of x dx equal to integral x1 to x2 f of x y of x plus alpha eta of x y dash of x plus alpha eta dash of x dx. Since y of x minimizes the value of the integral I and y bar of x equal to y of x when alpha equal to 0, I of alpha must have a minimum value when alpha equal to 0. Thus, it follows from elementary calculus that I dash of alpha equal to 0 when alpha equal to 0. Consider I dash of alpha. I dash of alpha equal to integral x1 to x2 dou by dou alpha of f of x y bar dash dx. Now consider dou by dou alpha of f of x y bar dash. It is equal to dou f by dou x into dou x by dou alpha plus dou f by dou y bar into dou y bar by dou alpha plus dou f by dou y bar dash into dou y bar dash by dou alpha. Since dou x by dou alpha equal to 0, dou y bar by dou alpha equal to eta of x and dou y bar dash by dou alpha equal to eta dash of x, we get dou by dou alpha of f of x y bar dash equal to dou f by dou y bar eta of x plus dou f by dou y bar dash eta dash of x. Thus, I dash of alpha become integral x1 to x2 dou f by dou y bar eta of x plus dou f by dou y bar dash eta dash of x dx. As we know that y bar of x equal to y of x and y bar dash of x equal to y dash of x when alpha equal to 0, the condition I dash of 0 equal to 0 become integral x1 to x2 dou f by dou y eta of x plus dou f by dou y dash eta dash of x dx equal to 0. Here the second term contains the term eta dash of x. To eliminate this term, we apply integration by parts to the second term and obtain integral x1 to x2 dou f by dou y dash into eta dash of x dx equal to dou f by dou y dash into eta of x between limits x1 to x2 minus integral x1 to x2 eta of x d by dx of dou f by dou y dash dx. As we know that eta of x1 equal to eta of x2 equal to 0, we get integral x1 to x2 dou f by dou y dash eta dash of x dx equal to minus of integral x1 to x2 eta of x into d by dx of dou f by dou y dash dx equal to 0. Therefore, equation 4 become integral x1 to x2 eta of x into dou f by dou y minus d by dx of dou f by dou y dash dx equal to 0. Since this must be true for all such functions eta of x, it follows that the term in the brackets must vanish. Hence, we get d by dx of dou f by dou y dash minus dou f by dou y equal to 0, which is the Euler's equation.
Thus, what we have shown is that if a function y of x minimizes the value of the integral I, then it satisfies the Euler's differential equation. But it does not mean that if a function y satisfies the Euler's differential equation, then it necessarily minimizes I. The solutions of the Euler's differential equation are termed as extremals. On applying the boundary conditions to the extremals, we obtain the stationary functions or stationary curves. Then we have to apply the methods in geometry and physics to ensure that such a curve y equal to y of x is actually a minimizing curve. We will consider the problems using the Euler's differential equation in the next part. Thank you.